Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our offline class. At present, we are in the social class. So, in this social class, in the previous class, we already discussed about the major contribution of Raja Ram Mohan Roy and also the young Bengali movement of Neroji Yog. Both contributions we have how to find out in the previous class. Now, it is a time to understand about what are the major contributions of Swami Dayananda Saraswati through their Arya Samaja. Okay, here Arya Samaja founded by Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Who is the founder of Arya Samaja? Arya Samaja was founded by Swami Dayananda Saraswati in the year. Swami Dayananda Saraswati. It is the first point. The second point, Dayananda Saraswati was born in 1824 in Kathiawar of Gujarat state. It is the one of the important point you have to understand. Swami Dayananda Saraswati was born in 1824 in Kathiawar district of Gujarat state. And his early name, Mula Shankara. What is the early name of Swami Dayananda Saraswati? The early name of Swami Dayananda Saraswati is Mula Shankara. Okay, you have to understand that point. And Amba Shankara Tiwari and Amrita Bhai were the parents of Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Who were the parents of Swami Dayananda Saraswati? The first one is Amba Shankara Tiwari and Amrita Bhai were the parents of Swami Dayananda Saraswati. He started the Arya Samaja in 1875. He started this Arya Samaja in the year of 1875. At Bombay. Okay. Then he wrote Satyartha Prakasha. Satyartha Prakasha, it is one of the great book and it contains moral ethics. So, he wrote a Satyartha Prakasha book. He declared that back to Vedas. Dear students, you have to understand this point very well. Why? Because in exam, in your final exam, they asked again and again, who given the statement back to Vedas? Back to Vedas slogan given by Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Why? Because Vedas contain, those are the source of truth and knowledge. That's why Vedas are the source of truth and knowledge. That's why he is given the sloka like that, back to Vedas. The next point we have to understand, the head of Arya Samaja is in Lahore in the year of 1877. He established this Arya Samaja and he made head office in Lahore. At present it is in Pakistan, but when before independence, Lahore is in India. That's why in the year of 1877, he had made or profounded the head office of Arya Samaja in Lahore. In the next, he started the Shuddhi movement. Shuddhi movement means what? Purification. It is also one more name, that is purification movement. Who started the purification movement? Swami Dayananda Saraswati started the purification movement. Okay. So, what is the meaning of purification movement or Shuddhi movement? So many religions people converted to other religions, but he had given more importance to Hindu religion. Why? Because Hindu religion contained like this Vedas. That's why Vedas are the source of truth and knowledge. That's why you should not convert to other religion. You should maintain the Hindu religion. Okay. Why? Because we are living in the Hindustana. That is the main point we have to understand from this point. Here, next, he started Cow Protection Association. A cow is considered a sacred animal to the Indians, especially Hindus. So when we are performing the puja functions, at the time we have to worship the cow. Why? Because it is considered go mata, it is in our mother tongue. That's why he started the cow protection Association also. And next, he started Dayananda Anglo Vedic College in the year of 1886. In the year of 1886, some of the followers of Arya Samaja, they started after the expire of Swami Dayananda Saraswati, the memorable contribution of Dayananda Saraswati, they established Dayananda Anglo Vedic College. Okay, the next point we have to understand, Gurukula Vidyalaya also started in there. In finally, we have to understand where we have to find out the Gurukula Vidyalaya. Gurukula Vidyalaya was started in Haridwara. Haridwara place, we have to find out the Gurukula Vidyalaya. Last, finally, who influenced very on the aggressive thoughts of this Arya Samaja, that freedom fighter? He was none other than Lala Lajpat Rai. Lala Lajpat Rai was very influenced by the Arya Samaja. Why? Because it contained more effective thoughts. Okay, this is the information we have to understand about the contributions of Dayananda Saraswati. Now it is the time to understand the important preachings of Arya Samaja. Here, first point, what are the major aims or objectives, intentions of Arya Samaja? The very first point, all Hindus should believe in one formless God. Here Swami Dayananda Saraswati given an important preaching. You should follow one God. Don't follow the formless God. Why? Because all God should perform in only one shape. God is one, but he has different names. That concept you have to understand. Okay. The next second point is that no one is a Shudra or a Brahmana by birth and caste based system. You won't follow the caste system. Why? Because caste system is the worst social evil. That's why you don't follow the caste system. No one Shudra is there, nobody Shudra in our society. We are all equal, said by the in their preaching of Swami Dayananda Saraswati. In the next one, encouragement to inter-caste marriages. He had given more importance to inter-caste marriages. The same caste marriages, that is quite common, but nowadays there is inter-caste marriages are going on in practice. Why? Because inter-caste marriages, those are considered offense, but they are supporting. Swami Dayananda Saraswati was supporting like this inter-caste marriage. And rejection of polygamy. What is the meaning of polygamy? A person having more than one wife, he is considered as polygamy. What is the opposite of polygamy? Polygamy opposite is the monogamy. Monogamy means a person have only one wife. He is considered as monogamy. Okay. He rejected the polygamy system and also child marriage. Don't do the child marriages in the early age of the children. Why? Because after in their further future, they are facing more effective problems. That's why no need to process like that practices. Finally, he said, men and women are equal. Both are equal. There is no more great. Man is not great, woman is not great. Both are equal. So you have to maintain both quality. Finally, one more point he said that is, one should study Vedas and other ancient sacred texts and preach them. So you should learn about Vedas. When you have to learn about the Vedas, Vedas are also having source of truth and knowledge. That's why you have to follow the Vedas, Vedas information or Vedas knowledge. So it is the information we have to understand in this class. Okay. In the next point is that is Prarthana Samaja. In that Prarthana Samaja, who is the founder of Prarthana Samaja? The Prarthana Samaja founder, Dr. Atmarama Panduranga. Atmarama Panduranga was the founder of this society in the year of 1867 at Bombay. Okay. So, what is the main intention of Prarthana Samaja? The aim of finding solution to various problems faced by women and lower caste groups. that is the remove from the society, that is the main intention of Prarthana Samaja. Okay, the next, what are the important aspects of Prarthana Samaja? Here the first one, to reject the child marriage. He also, Dr. Atmarama Panduranga, also rejected the child marriage, to curb the discrimination on widows, and he has given more importance the widows remarriage, and he supported to education for women. The next point, he encouraged widow remarriage, and he had given more helping hand to rehabilitation of poor people. That is the most important thing we have to understand from this period. Here the final one, after death of Dr. Atmarama Panduranga, who led the Prarthana Samaja? Here M.G. Ranade. What is the full name of M.G. Ranade? Mahadeva Govinda Ranade. So R.G. Bandarkar and N.G. Chandavakar were the prominent leaders to lead the Prarthana Samaja after the Dr. Atmarama Panduranga. So in this class we have to understand two major society or samaja. One is Arya Samaja and one more is Prarthana Samaja. In the next class we have to understand about Satya Shodhaka Samaja by Jyoti Bapule. Okay, thank you.